The Southern Symphony Experience started as the tiniest little idea of I wanted to just combine the entire album into one video. So from top to bottom, every single song, one click, that's all I wanted. And so I talked to my boy Spencer and I was like, dude, I have this idea, some sort of video, even if it's just a couple pictures or, you know, a quick video. I don't know. I didn't really know at that point what I wanted it to be.
Remember when Russ told me this idea, we were out on a run and I was so excited about it. We talked for months about different concepts and ideas. But what I knew I wanted to see from it is the transitions, not only from the music, but the real world audio. And so kind of relating those two worlds together was kind of hard to figure out until all of a sudden I was in line at a coffee shop and it just like hit me like a ton of bricks that, man, we should do this at a motel. So I instantly called Russ up and I said, dude, here's the idea. And he was like, 100%, yes, we got to do this.
Spencer and I think Daniela found this place called the Dive Motel in East Nashville. It's like this crazy old vibey motel, swim club, and every single room is different, which was perfect for this video. We shot a lot of this stuff for the album in Palm Springs, and so the dance floor is exactly like the hotel that we stayed at in Palm Springs for the photo shoot, the video shoot for Love You Like I Used To. 100% on brand with the entire aesthetic of the album.
Let's go ahead and like wrap this way, because he came in, he's coming back, and then we're gonna wrap around here, because we can.
Like, I saw the smoky bar for Never Get Old, and me and my buddy Taylor made up an entire line dance for Never Get Old just for this video. So you know that's gonna be on TikTok ASAP. And you know I had to put a little sauce on there. I had to put a little, drip a little RD sauce on those dance moves. And you know, pulled from a little TikTok library that I've been storing up. And you know, you'll see some of those dance moves up in the Never Get Old dance hall scene. I think one of my favorite parts of this entire video is when the All Yours All Night couple goes into their room, and then the owners of the hotel are walking us to ours, and they see the All Yours All Night couple and they're like, oh, hey. And then we keep walking. Love You Like I Used To is playing. They let us into our room.
They're gonna go into the room and you're gonna snuggle into Bob right here. So Bob, I'm gonna put you right here. I'll move that in a second. So she'll snuggle into him. Just like that, and you're watching them. So it's kind of this moment. Then go down and you're both gonna turn back into each other and go to hold hands with these hands and walk away.
Action!
It just focuses on the owners of the hotel for a second, and the look that they give each other of like, you know, like we remember that phase. We remember the newborn phase and the even the All Yours All Night phase. Just like, you can just see the memories flooding back in this couple's eyes, and like I tear up every time I see that scene. It's such a sweet moment because that perfectly sums up Love You Like I Used To. That's like that was the most like sentimental moment, but I think my favorite part like shooting this video is when Home Sweet's playing. It's me, Kales, and Remington. We like fall back on the bed and the camera continues through the wall and like the sound fades out and there's this girl in there on her phone. And that to me is when it goes from like kind of music video to like full-on cinema Hollywood production.
When I first envisioned this whole thing, I pictured transitions like that, you know, and I wrote them down in the treatment. It's like, how do you go from one song through a wall to the next and you hear it in the other room, but it's kind of quiet and muted and you hear her phone and the fan going, and then the next transition hitting with the headphones going in. That this whole sequence from them in the bedroom to her in the room to the pool was probably one of my favorite moments of transitions, because there's so much going on that you may not even notice. I mean, you've got through the wall happening, her texting, then Sam holding the camera over her head, swooping down, following her through, going through the doorway. The pool scene already had to be set up. Hand off camera, over the rail, and then the guy jumps in the pool, and everything hitting at the right times. I mean, this took so much like pre-production thought, and I just love how that turned out. I mean, and then when he jumps in the pool, I mean, let's just talk about that whole scene in general. I mean, that, the whole vision for this was, you know, we were talking through color palette, is how can we bring the colors to life and make you feel things? And it's like, when he jumped in the water, initially what I wanted to hear, him diving into the pool, and then you hear the song go under the water and come back up, so you feel like you're a part of that experience. And so, and then it's just the bright, the fun, and how do we create that moment? I mean, we had the scissor crane going across the water. We had Nick, our incredible DP, actually jumped in the water with his fish tank and was shooting under the water. And I mean, there was just so many incredible, there's just so many incredible moments throughout the whole shoot that I'm just absolutely so proud of. And I can't, I still can't believe we were able to pull this whole thing off.
It's about time for a drink. It's about time for a cold one. It's about time for a throwback. Maybe a country gold one. Yeah, I've been waiting on a night like this. It's about time for a drink. It's about time for a drink. Yeah,
I know. I saw the special, like, it's sort of a bee sting. Like,
too much.
Yeah,
too much.
Dude, thank you for jumping in there.
Yeah, yeah.
I know it's cold. Love you guys so much.